Are you ready?
WebRadio.com, your internet radio destination for the new millennium. Live anytime,
on any day,
from anywhere. It's WebRadio.com. Nothing can compare to what's happening across the network. So come listen to this station live at WebRadio.com with music,
news,
sports,
whatever your taste,
it's there. WebRadio also has some cool giveaways all the time. Be sure to check it out. WebRadio.com.
Good evening. Look, Richard, this is where I have to run my promos now from this manual player. This is our guest tonight, Blanca Blanco. This is her demo. This is her demo reel. Okay, here we go.
I would like to know the procedures and paperwork form.
Yeah.
I'm taking a break from school.
You want to drop out?
No, I'm not sure. I just want to know what the procedures are for just taking a break.
Just fill this out, turn it in, you'll be all set. Next.
That is Blanca Blanco. Did you see her outside, Augie?
Nothing
yet. Okay, KCLAFM.com. If you're wondering what's going on, this is the Pocho Loco Show. That's the only way I could open the show with this manual thing. I'll have to talk to our engineer about that.
I was expecting Augie to have a red, something red, maybe over his face.
Red?
Yeah.
Red what? Headphones?
Well, he does have a set of red headphones, as a matter of fact. But I was thinking about that red bikini up there.
Oh, well, that's Blanca Blanco. Yes, that's what's coming in tonight, hopefully.
Well, we were all impatient.
Okay, well, then let's get the show started. You two did a gracious thing over the weekend, this past week. They gave up their stage as they were performing in Paris to the group Eagles of Death Metal, which is a Palm Desert group out here in California, and they were playing at the Bataclan concert hall. Of course, when those terrorists, those SOBs, those bastards, struck, and so he gave the stage up because it blew their concert, not by their own fault, a tragic occurrence. The way that The Edge, Bono, Adam Clayton, Larry Mullen, drummer, yeah, they give it stage. So, but you know the thing, and that's a good, that like I said, that's a gracious thing that Bono did. And the thing is, Richard, you know, he still cannot count in Spanish.
Dos, dos, tres, catorce.
Turn it up, Captain.
Lights go down, it's dark. The jungle is your head. Can't rule your heart. I'm feeling so much stronger than I thought. Your eyes are wide, and though your soul, it can't be bought. Your mind can wander.
Hello, hello.
heard you got a new car, Howie.
Just a car, Terry. It's a classic.
So are you a tennis ball on a string guy or more of a cork and fishing line guy?
You mean, do I have something dangling from the ceiling of my garage so I don't run into the wall?
Exactly.
I'm a little more technologically advanced than that, Terry.
Oh.
The ultrasonic parking alert from Radio Shack with signal lights that tell you when to stop. Only $39.99. One of many cool things you don't even know you need. Like the digital tire gauge, just $11.99. Radio Shack.
Hi, down here, it's your mouth. Listen up, let's get some things straight, okay? A, I'm not a bottle opener, all right? B, wait until the pizza cools down. I'm tired of having the roof peeled for 3 days. And for Pete's sake, buy me some Coolman Listerine. It's proven to kill the germs that can cause gingivitis, which, by the way, 2 out of 3 mouths get before we're 25. So get some, huh? Otherwise, you might find me, your mouth, saying a little something unexpected on your next date, like, hi, my name's Mike, and I just love biting my toenails. Capiche?
See your dentist. Use as directed when brushing and flossing aren't enough.
It started out like a totally normal day.
I love you.
I mean, I guess I was a little sweaty, and I was definitely sore. I thought I had gas. Turns out, I was having a heart attack. Heart disease is the number one killer of American women. So now I take care of myself and tell the other women in my life to do the same. Make it your mission to save your life and the lives of the women you love. Find out more from the American Heart Association at goredforwomen.org.
For all of your auto repairs, including expert collision work, LA Radiator on Santa Monica Boulevard is the place to go. Located just a few steps east of Vine, LA Radiator offers the fastest service at the lowest cost available anywhere in the area. Whether it's just a tune-up or a major repair, you'll be putting your car in the best hands possible. Don't let the name LA Radiator fool you. They do a lot more than just radiators. Remember, the next time your car needs any repair, try LA Radiator at 6216 Santa Monica Boulevard, located just a few steps east of Vine Street in Hollywood.
It's everything I wish I didn't know. But you give me something I can feel.
I've seen these guys about 2 or 3 times in concert. Love their music.
Oh, that was a bad song, man. I like that. You yeah, you got a good choice of music going there, Pocho.
I made a mistake last week when I was trying to
slam jam. Thank you, man.
I'm trying to schmooze over Rocio last week.
Yeah.
With the music. I should have realized, she likes the merengue, that type of music, I think. No, I was playing that soft stuff.
Got one up on her, don't we, tonight?
What's that? Oh, I don't know. She's not here.
Lady in Red, who hasn't shown up.
Blanca's not here. I would know.
The Gear, what's his name? Richard Gere's.
Richard Gere.
Yeah, Richard Gere, Lady in Red.
You are so misinformed.
The Lady in Red. Is that Lopez up there, or who is that?
No, that's Blanca Blanco.
Oh, well, she's got a pair of nice hips. But I understand that she has a lover in her life. Is that what you told me earlier?
Lover, man. How do you describe her like that?
Oh, I feel sorry for him. I feel sorry for him.
Come on now. We don't want to get personal, too personal. She's not even in here yet.
Well, that's why I'm getting personal before she gets here. I know she can't be listening to the show on her way here.
She might. She just might.
Well, she might be at the front door trying to get in.
Well, why don't you go check Augie?
No, Augie doesn't.
Go check.
No, no, I just ran upstairs, I got a health problem.
Oh,
I can't do all that.
Hurry up, I want to do the sports.
Since I'm so young and energetic, I will go.
Okay.
Yeah, you go make the run. You go make the run, not me, because I went upstairs to get the
disc. Okay. I have something else. I have something else to get to before we go to sports anyway. And that is the Nosotros party. That was over there at the Montreon.
The Sky Barn.
I think, you got to be careful there because I prefer the W myself, but they have a pool in the middle of the bar area.
Oh, really?
A swimming pool.
Oh, really? So you get drunk, you fall in the pool,
twice,
you drown, huh?
Twice, I had to skip around people. People don't get it. When there's a pool nearby and you're drinking, especially Shivas, because Shivas was sponsoring, the show Shivers, you know, that's whiskey. That's Scotch whiskey.
Oh, I missed a good party, man.
And that was free for about an hour.
I got Irish blood. I should have been there.
Yeah, and
I'm surprised.
And anyway, when people are drinking and you got a pool nearby, there's a possibility that you might fall in. And I almost, two times, you know, and people don't look.
Well, you know what? That's a perfect scene for a movie right there, man. A party pool. Well, they didn't do it on Straight Outta Compton. They had a pool party, and people were drinking. You didn't see anybody falling in the pool.
That was some pool party.
I think you was. Have you seen that yet?
Yeah, of course. I told you.
I thought you said last week you haven't even seen the movie
yet.
No,
I told you. I have seen the film, and I've even critiqued it and put it up on Facebook. But anyway.
Well, I didn't catch it, so.
You know, the thing is, Richard, you know where this is at? Where this hotel is at?
Yeah, Sky Bar. I've been there. You know who likes to go there?
What are you doing there?
Well, you know who likes to go there, right?
No, who?
What's his name? The guy who plays the teacher in...
Edward James Olmos?
Edward James Olmos.
Well, I don't know if I'm going to go there, but it's right across from...
I seen him there.
It's right across from the Comedy Store.
I saw him jump out of a two-seater. He had a two-seater little sports car, yeah.
And
Edward
going
James Olmos. Here she is.
Did he have a date?
Your girl's in.
Did he have a date?
Well, I would let him handle that. Did he have a date? He probably did.
I'm asking you.
I'm sure he did. Well, it's James Olmos. What do you think?
I don't know, but I like it at the W.
All right.
And anyway, Richard, I'm not done talking about the bar.
Oh, I'm listening.
Come on in, have a seat.
I'm listening.
Blanca, we already started. Yeah.
Welcome.
Welcome.
Have a seat. So anyway, you know, that's one of the danger hazards of pool parties.
Yeah.
You know, you just didn't. Did you fall in?
No, I didn't fall in. But I you know, I made a lot of connections, and Laura Sixtos and some of the others were saying, "Well, that's why you're not."
Well, how come I didn't see you? I was there. You missed me. You didn't see me.
You're not connecting up with anybody. But I had. I came away with a pocket.
Ah, Marches.
I saw him.
Al was there.
I saw him.
Wilson was there. Who else was there? The boxer guy was there. Well, you didn't see me there.
You did not go. You did not go. That's
you missed
how,
me. You must have been really drinking.
No, the crowd thinned out quickly. The crowd thinned out quickly. And I got to see everybody's face two or three times. I said, that's enough. I'm going back to the LBC.
Okay, well.
Okay.
The crowd thinned out. I couldn't find you. It was worse than the Legacy. I couldn't find you at the Legacy either.
Yeah, get out of the way. I can't see my guest.
Blanca.
Hi. Oh my goodness. Did I hear what I just heard?
What?
Un beso. Un beso. Oh, un besos. Un besos in the house, you mean?
I gave Rocio a beso when I caught her up in the hallway, unplanned. On both cheeks. On both cheeks.
We're going to call you the beso man from now on.
El beso, el beson.
I didn't think you were going to make it back, Augie. I thought maybe you were going to end up with maybe some a blindfold on and a color
Blanca,
of red.
Were you waiting out there long, Mija?
No, I actually, it was easy to get here. But he was outside at the right time.
Did he scare you?
Well, he was outside at the right time.
Did Augie scare you?
He had his headphones, so I thought, okay, he's...
You should speak into the microphone. You need to slide up because the mic won't be able to pick you up.
Yeah, but I was going to get that. Go ahead.
Don't try to get her to sit on your lap. Okay?
Augie, give her the... Give her a headphone and give her the mic for a sec.
Yeah, so, yeah.
I only got one.
Huh?
I
no.
Got one with me.
There's one. There should be enough for everybody. Look, 99 Cent Store had a sale.
Untangle that. That's got to get untangled.
Okay.
It's on my 99 cent pair of shoes.
No.
Okay, move up closer. Just a little bit closer. Okay, go ahead. All right,
yeah.
Now what's the story?
So it wasn't hard to find. I mean, it was, he came outside at the right time. So
got timing. I got timing, buddy.
Yeah, and he had a headphone, so I thought, okay, I think he's with the radio.
You didn't think he was like a Mexicana?
No, I didn't think he was a weirdo.
Are you Mexicana?
Yeah, I'm Mexicana.
I didn't know that. See, I thought it's a
Blanca. How did you know that? What?
How did I know that? You mentioned somewhere in Facebook that your parents are migrant workers and something about you, Mexicana, and so I thought, wow, she's Mexican.
Yeah, I was born here, but when I was 3 months, we moved to Mexico until I was 8.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. You know, see, the reason why I asked you're Mexicana because a lot of Mexicanos believe in UFOs, you know.
Oh.
And I thought maybe you thought with those headphones this guy was an alien.
No,
an alien. He's legal too. He's Latino too. Who papeles? No, no importa. No, but anyway, as long as you're over there with Augie, you know, we're gonna because
she was in good hands. Don't worry about it.
Anyway, final comment I want to make about we had this party over at the Montreal Nosotros, you know, Christmas party.
Okay.
And the last comment I want to make about that, you saw everybody's pictures, right, Richard? You saw everybody's pictures.
Absolutely, absolutely. Like you said, the house was full of fabulous A people, like Laura Sittles. I told you, I couldn't see you, though. Where were you hiding?
That's what I'm saying. See, everybody, Augie, got their pictures taken, but me. The photographer was over there. I guess I didn't have a babe in my hand.
A baby?
A babe. Una nena. Una nena. Una chavala, you know. Don't make me go into the other words. But morra. I didn't have a morra with me, so that's, you know.
Well, you have a year to prepare for the next holiday party.
Well, sure. If I make it.
Better luck next time.
Anyway, do you like sports? Do you play sports?
I do. I'm a runner. And I play soccer. I'm not that great at soccer, but I can score.
Chivas or America?
Chivas, but I don't really, you know, I prefer to play than to watch.
Did you play in high school?
Yeah, I did.
You did, really? Where that was in Washington, right?
Hmm?
You went to high school in Washington?
Yeah, I went to high school in Washington, and I did track and volleyball.
See? And stand-up. Can you
Nothing
stand
like an athletic woman.
Can you stand up for a second? Is she 5'10", Augie?
I don't know. I'll measure her after the show.
See, you stand up, I'll stand up.
She's not wearing high heels either.
I'm 5'11", so she's 5'10".
She's about 5'8", 5'10". Man, golly, Blanca.
Tall women look good in stilettos, even so.
5'11 and 3'4".
So she can be 5'11", 5'10", and then she'll be 6'4".
Blanca, I don't understand.
They look good in stilettos.
Why do guys always look at the patas? You know? I always look at women's feet.
Hey, you know what? She doesn't have big feet either. Look.
They're size 10.
Oh, they don't look big with those little shoes.
See, that
my flats.
She's wearing.
See the line behind the mic over here. These two guys, they get to see all the models that are coming in. I'm so happy. You don't know how happy I'm here.
I like to know when is your birthday, if you don't mind. Not the year, but the date, the month.
No, don't do that. You know, this guy, astrología.
What are you going to do?
It's
like
un brujo, man. He thinks he can tell. Oh, you're a Sagittarius.
I can tell.
Okay, what is it?
You know what? No, I didn't say I could tell what you are.
Tell me your sign.
I can tell more about you.
I'm January.
Oh, so you are Aquarius, aren't you?
Yes.
Oh, do you know you and I have a fatal attraction?
Hey, Walter. Hey, Walter.
Oh, okay.
Because I'm Leo. I'm July 29th, so Aquarius women have a thing about me.
Oh, yeah?
But then when they turn to hate, then they're the worst. It's like a whole different thing. I don't know. The air puts out. No, air should feed fire, but there's some water you guys carry, right? And I'm a lion. You know how lions are about water, right?
Yeah. Hey, Walter.
Yeah.
Hey, Walter.
My ex-wife was Aquarius.
Hey.
And so was my my ex-girlfriend. You know, exes. Yeah.
Blanca.
Oh, so like, you stick with the Aquarius.
You run to an Aries when, you know, you did.
Hey, go.
When he's, you find out he's defective, you just run to Aries, okay? He'll take care of you.
Hey. Blanca.
I think you lost on this one.
Blanca, do you know Walter? You know that guy, Walter?
Which Walter?
He's the guy, you don't know if he's a mujer or
hombre. Oh, Walter Mercado or something like that?
That does the astrology, that guy.
Yes, of course. I used to see him growing up.
Galen. You're talking about Galen. Kalen. You mean Jenner?
Oh, no, not Jenner.
I know the guy on the Spanish station who does all the horoscope stuff. Right.
Like rings everywhere.
You know, we ran your promo, your promo reel from YouTube.
Yeah.
In the beginning of the show, and you can hear it when we put it on YouTube. You can hear the show, the beginning.
Yeah.
And there's that one last part where you're strangling a guy or something.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Was that a horror film?
Yeah, it was definitely a horror film.
Yeah.
It wasn't a family film.
It didn't look like. And how about the Showgirls film? What was that? Showgirls?
Oh, yes. I played a star dancer. Mm-hmm. I was the lead dancer in this movie, and it was fun working. That was like so many years ago.
Okay.
I'm a ballroom dancer, Fred Astaire.
If he gets out of hand,
Trot, waltz, tango, chop. You know, I gotta take you do some mambo.
If he gets out of hand, I want you to strangle him the way you were strangling that guy in the last part of the primo world. Okay, Augie, some things I got to get done with you.
So is it sports time?
Yeah, finally, all last right. 2 minutes. But it's okay because I spent half of it with Blanca.
That's okay.
I wouldn't eat that, man. Is she pretty? You mentioned Carolina will be in the playoffs. I am predicting that Carolina will get beaten in the playoffs, you know, in the NFL playoffs. Yeah,
they are running the table, undefeated.
Yeah, it's not going to happen.
You know, they've had a few little problems with teams stepping up because everybody wants to knock them off the pedestal. But I'm predicting, I'm telling you right now, they're going to run the table. They're going to win it all. Okay? So that takes care of that.
Okay. Now, let's see. Now, Kobe last, the Lakers lost again. Do you like basketball, Blanca?
Yes, I like basketball.
But you don't like, teams like the Lakers, huh?
Oh, they're okay. I mean,
they only want threats. Tres partidos, that's it, man. Just
well, at least they're consistent.
see, how she's Mexicana, she's smart, she knows how to answer, Augie. Where can I find a woman like that?
The Laker organization has made a lot of mistakes in the last few years, so.
Really?
Hey, but look, right now they want to lose as much as they can because there's a player at LSU by the name of Ben Simmons.
I know who he is.
He'll be the number one pick. And the Lakers want him. So well, they're tank. They may even be tanking.
Augie, you know, he didn't even finish out. Richie didn't even finish out the first quarter last night. And he sat down and watched the rest of the young players play. I mean, how can you sit in front of your cable box and watch that kind of a game?
The Lakers went in overtime and they lost by 1 point.
They still lost.
Yeah, but nonetheless, they were competitive. No. And so they weren't too bad.
So how many years do you think they have, realistically, before they come back and be what they used to be?
Well, if they get that draft pick, they'll be right in the picture right away. Because they have three outstanding young players. With one player, it can make a big difference, yes.
Well, yeah. I still hold a grudge against Kobe because of his not getting along with, what's his name?
Shaq. Way back in the day.
Yeah, because of him, I think the Lakers missed out on a lot of, at least two more championships with
Shaq.
Yeah,
but Shaq was never in shape. He would work his way and get in shape during the season, and Kobe didn't like that. So that's where they feuded. That was the major reason there.
Now, this is the reason why I want to move the show back to Wednesday, perhaps. Because when I left here, I left here early, and with Richard, and I took him home. And by the time I got back to the LBC, I didn't even go there. I went to Hooters Southgate. And as I walked in, the game was over, and they were showing the replays, the highlights. And, of course, the last play, last by Rodgers, last touchdown pass, final seconds, caught it in the end zone, and they beat the Lions. Did you see it?
I caught it on replay. I don't really pay attention to the Packers.
I saw it on replay too, but yeah. You saw it, huh?
They're a secondary team, lower tier team. They'll be in the playoffs and make a little noise, but that's about it. They'll lose it by the second game in their playoffs. They'll lose.
No.
They might win one.
You see this?
If they're lucky.
This is what makes a lot of noise right here.
Oh, yes.
You see that? That one makes a lot of noise. I got to. Thanks for putting those pictures.
Woman in red.
Taking those pictures. Because I'm telling you, I didn't know that you had swimsuits.
Woman in red. Where's Richard Gere? I'm Richard.
I didn't know you had.
Robertson. Yes.
I didn't know you had Richard Gere was an actor. And the thing just lit up. Facebook, all the likes just coming in. You're a very popular person on Facebook. A lot of people like you. Did you know that? Were you aware of that? Do you ever check your Facebook?
Well, I do. I mean, of course. I know I have followers on Facebook, and it's always nice to get their messages and comments and likes.
Mm-hmm. Well, you got quite a few with that, let me tell you. Mm-hmm. Well, not only that, but, you know, some of the older guys, they like you, and I knew they would like this. With you in those dresses and the red carpet. Mm-hmm. And, of course, these two guys, well, maybe Richard checked them out, but they don't pay attention to this kind of stuff.
Oh, you'd be really surprised what his conversation was all about when we were on the way over here. And he was behind the wheel listening to Tom Lankus. But let me explain something.
This guy
was definitely saying that he went on the internet and did his own research. Mr. Scotland Yard here.
Because I sent him pictures this afternoon. That's the
I know she was born in Watsonville. Yeah, I know a lot about her. And she, you know what's really nice about you? is that you're not wearing makeup and she still looks nice.
Are you not?
Yeah.
I tell.
She doesn't need makeup.
Tell.
It's like me. Look, I don't need makeup either. So we got that in common.
Tell him,
we're
Blanca.
Twins.
Tell him, Blanca. I've always said, Augie, that Hispanic women, whether Centro or Mexicana or whatever, Puerto Ricanas, they look even better without makeup. Yeah. They can never go wrong. Isn't that true, Richard? You are blocking my. I can't even see Blanca. You know, he's doing it on purpose. He's doing it on purpose.
He's blocking. I won't say what, but he's blocking.
It's like a defensive move in sports. They're blocking me out, so I can't get to the basket. They're blocking me out. But anyway, let's say anything else. Chase Utley, signed by the Dodgers for a year. $1 million for a year. Can you imagine that? How many Mexicanos make that kind of money? None. And do you think he's worth it?
I think he is because he still has a little in the tank. And he can teach those young players. The Dodgers have a lot of young players. And he can teach them how to hustle out there. And he can't steal bases, but he runs the bases very well.
Well, how old is he?
He's about 35, I believe. He's 35 years old. Yeah.
And don't forget the most important thing about Chase.
Yeah.
So January what?
He doesn't chase bad balls.
No.
22?
Long Beach High.
Oh, that's right. He's from your hometown.
Yeah. He's from my high school. Yeah. That's right. And and also at the Montreal last night, Rich, I think I can pick up a little bit of your conversation. It's okay. No, Blanca, it's never your. It's
it was his fault.
We're with this last comment, and we cut the break. The next half hour, you're coming up to. You're taking that chair, and the rest of the time is your time.
It's gonna be you. It's all
you. Ay, Dios mío, dame paciencia. Augie.
Yes,
at the Montreal Tuesday night,
Tuesday,
at the party,
yeah.
At the Nosotros party, I think I may have found a co-host for us.
Really? Oh, really?
Yeah, she's a light-skinned African-American.
Skinned it.
No, I didn't skin her. She's a light-skinned.
It's skinned it. And anyway, go ahead.
Hold on a minute.
Skinned is something you do out there. Carne asada, you know.
If you did find a co-host, I guess you were pretty satisfied with her, right?
Well, I knew you guys would like her.
Because I know your choice in women.
She's dark, African-American, but she's mixed up with everything else.
She's a hybrid then, huh?
And I'll send you, mezclada.
Good hair.
Is it? See, I got a Spanish major here. Blanca, is that a correct word, mezclada, when you say a person is of a different background?
Mezclada, pues yo digo así.
¿Sí?
I say that.
Sí,
I don't know.
Ese que él cree que sabe todo.
My second wife was from El Salvador, and she spoke Spanish, but she was Aquarius, too.
Oh, God.
But we were all 8 years, but then all of a sudden the eight-year itch happened.
All right. There you go. And Blanca, in honor of you being here, and in honor of your picture, I better change the picture. You know, I picked this little number for you here.
It's
okay,
thing,
and you'll know what
that's
it is.
That's why Playboy is successful, and so is other women magazines that men are very, stand behind. Mm-hmm.
If I can get it, go ahead, keep talking. I'm going to get after.
Playboy is becoming obsolete. They're not going to have.
All right, I'm just going to cut the commercial. Forget this, man.
Playboy's obsolete.
This guy.
You can't forget about Playboy.
Yeah. Well, look at this.
The magazine.
All right, forget it.
Now, there are still Playboys in existence.
Leo, you need to get in
but the
here
magazine
one of these days and help me
done.
With my help me with the machine. They're just not working. Sorry, folks, we'll be back with that.
Okay,
I'm going to cut the commercial. There we go.
This is Dirty Diana. I'll make your wildest dreams come true for just $3.95 a minute. Hello, this is Madame Diana's psychic hotline. Die here, rise on rainy Sunday in a second, 3-1.
Need extra cash? Log on to www.gotajob.com and apply for 10 jobs in 10 seconds. For employees, call 1-800-GOT-A-JOB.
Ooh, I'm wearing a lace teddy. What are you wearing?
My Sunday dress and an apron.
Grandma?
Gotajob.com. Part-time, full-time, in no time.
It sits there looking like a candy bar in a nice orange wrapper, right? Reese's Nutrageous. Then you take a bite and it blows your eyeballs to Pluto, kicks your ribs to the roof of your mouth, pounds your taste buds into a simpering puddle of pulp and leaves you for dead. Want one, don't ya?
Yeah.
Reese's Nutrageous. So loaded.
Chocolate.
And Reese's Peanut Butter.
You don't eat it. You survive it.
Every morning you shave the same area. Over and over. Till it becomes really irritating. But now there's Gillette Mach 3. Three blades that shave progressively closer. You take one stroke, it takes three. So you don't have to shave the same area over and over. The result, far less irritation. Three blades, fewer strokes, less irritation. Mach 3. From Gillette.
Are you ready?
WebRadio.com, your internet radio destination for the new millennium. Live anytime.
On any day.
From anywhere. It's WebRadio.com. Nothing can compare to what's happening across the network. So come listen to this station live at WebRadio.com with music,
news,
sports,
whatever your taste,
it's there. WebRadio also has some cool giveaways all the time. Be sure to check it out. WebRadio.com. WebRadio.com.
Well, East Coast girls are hip. I really dig those styles they wear. They knock me out when I'm down there. The Midwest farmer's daughters really make you feel alright. And the northern girls with the way they kiss, they keep their boyfriends warm at night.
Oh boy.
Yeah.
Alright. That was the one I was trying to get to before commercial break. Blanca Blanco is in the house with us on this special edition of the Actress Model Series. And with all due respect, here we go. Sorry, Wilson Brothers. Okay, now, as Augie mentioned, you are from Watsonville. But I didn't catch the last part. What you were now, that is that near San Francisco? Because I passed that.
Oh, what's
is your name Blanca Blanco?
Oh, sorry. I have my assistant here. Oh, helping
okay.
Me.
Oh my God, he's an archaeologist as well, and he knows about geography and it, is not near San Francisco. I did pass through it. Where's it at?
It's near Santa Cruz. It's Santa Cruz County.
Oh, okay. I think that's when we took the trip up to San Francisco along the one, which was a mistake. My kid. Yeah, that was a mistake. That's far. That's long. And then now, I did not know you would move to Mexico.
Yeah, so when I was 3 months, we moved to Mexico. Uh-huh. In Colima, Tecomán, Colima.
I know Colima.
And so I went to school there when I was like in, you know, preschool.
Mm-hmm.
And then when I was closer to, I guess 7, we moved back to Washington State.
Now, why Washington? I don't understand that. It's so cold up there.
Well, yeah, but my parents went there.
Oh, boy, so yeah, follow mom and dad.
We had to follow them. And
in this country, they might get arrested. Go ahead.
And so my dad's side of the family, they were there. And so I love it. I mean, I went to school there. I went to elementary school, middle school, high school, and college. Am I too loud or what?
No. Now you're fine. You know, all you're right. Okay. I want it perfect, though.
Oh, okay.
I want it perfect. You know, you're Mexicana, so you know. I'm Mexicana. Well, actually, no, Richie Rich, no. This is Rockin' Richie. Yeah. The reason why I put this picture up.
Mm-hmm. Why?
Well, for obvious reasons. I'm from Southern California, LA, raised also in Orange County,
mm-hmm.
and this was my childhood growing up. Yours was up there in Washington.
This en la nieve.
A la, a la nieve, con la nieve. And I was here, bored stiff as a kid, watching this. No, but you with the surfboard.
I was stiff as a board.
Come on. No paga atención a ese. Es mal educado, man.
Pocho, that's an interesting picture because she doesn't seem... She doesn't seem to have the waistline or the hips that we see here.
Hit him. Hit him, Blanca. Hit him, Blanca. Hit him with your... I wish you had your safe one.
Was this a download?
No, you are.
No, that was like a year ago.
He just said she doesn't look like she should be on the beach.
No, I mean, it's just...
You look like...
She looks like a surfer girl. That's why I played the song.
I don't know. That was only a year ago. That was it looks good. You haven't changed much in a year, have you?
No, I haven't.
Then they don't. They don't.
You know, I don't know. I don't want you to take that personal. I'm just saying...
He's from Chicago.
I noticed it a little bit. Yeah, I'm from Chicago, so you know.
But both of us are from East LA.
Yeah.
Oh, so
yeah.
We have similar tastes.
We like hot women. We don't like tree trunks.
Tree trunks? What are they?
I don't know.
I don't know. Anyway. No, I'm doing the interview. Richard, I'll give you a chance to ask some questions. But this got a lot of hits. This one. And it was from all LA guys, and this is because this is what we're accustomed to.
Well, it got a lot of hits in France. It was published in France.
Of course.
La diferencia es que ellos ponen calzones. ellos usan calzones para nadar.
Bonjour, come on back too.
What, do you wear calzones too when you go swimming? The Speedos, Augie? Okay, here we go. Speedo or swim trunks?
Swim trunks, but when they were in style, I did wear Speedos. I did.
Yeah, right.
Un pajarito.
Accentuation, yeah, you know?
Yeah. So you were the weirdo in the water, like, with your Speedo, huh?
And what about your Speedo? Okay.
No, I'm going with trunks. I'm going with boxing
There you go. That's how
I'm a Laker fan. I go with boxing trunks. You know, Muhammad Ali, you know, that kind of thing. Now, Speedos was in the old school
for
me.
All right, now give it back to her. Now give it back to her. Thank you. Thank you. But see, that's my thing. If you're raised in Southern California, you know, you don't use those Speedos. And I believe you when you say about those guys in France. They're crazy about that, but they wear Speedos.
Oh, I'm wearing Speedos. Wearing
trunks. No, we don't want to see it.
We don't want to see it.
Sit down. And boxers or briefs for calzones. Southern Cal guys wear boxers.
We're boxers right now.
We do not wear the... briefs, you know, calzones. We use box, and you know why? You know why?
Why?
So if we have to go outside, in front of our house to pick up our newspaper or anything like that,
you're in your boxers.
People think, oh, he just got his swim trunks on.
Oh, that's like, so
yeah.
You're
trying to avoid changing again. So that's like,
yeah,
being like a little bit lazy there.
But ask a woman's opinion.
Okay, come on. I got to get on. Rich, I got to get on with this interview, man. She's got a lot to... Okay. yeah, you're a graduate of Washington State.
I'm a cougar.
She's a cougar, but not like that.
Not like that.
The mascot.
Not yet, anyway.
No, God.
So,
she doesn't need to be, pal.
I went to Washington State University for psychology, mm-hmm. and then I graduated, and then I got my master's at Eastern Washington University in social work.
I'm glad you mentioned that.
My daughter has a
master's. Because a lot of the young ladies that have been on the show, they seem to all have college degrees, and I'm all for higher education, of course, you know, for Hispanics to mm-hmm. progress and get ahead and get better paying jobs and all that. Now, you know, you moved to Hollywood after Washington State. You came down here.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm just curious, where did you first live when you came to Hollywood?
My God, when I moved here, I live in Victorville.
Wait a second, so that's out the other way.
Yes,
man.
I know. So my aunt, she said, oh, Blanca, you can stay with us until you move, so that way then you can take your time to look for a place. And she's like, I'm close to L.A. And I said, oh, you are? And I didn't even think about, like, Googling, because she just thought, oh, I go there all the time. So I don't mind driving long distance, but I didn't realize it was going to be 2 hours one way. And so I only lasted there, like, a month. And then I found a place, and then I live in Pasadena.
Nice.
What do you mean nice? It's hot up there.
Pasadena?
No, I didn't go there.
Pasadena, no. Have you been to Bessel's, Eva Longoria's restaurant?
Yes,
here?
I've been there before.
You like it?
Yeah, they have good food.
No, I've never eaten there. They have comida mexicana.
Where's that?
I had appetizers.
Yeah. Well, at least the appetizers.
Oh, they were good.
All right. Yeah.
It's on Hollywood.
I just haven't tried the food there, and it's sometimes it's hard to find, you know, place with good Mexican food.
Oh, I know that's hard.
Pasadena.
Yeah. You need to go out to East LA.
Oh, go to Madres in West Hollywood.
Madres. What street is that on?
Santa Monica Boulevard.
Yes.
See, I told you.
He knows everything.
Es sabe todo, this guy.
So.
Because he's looking it up right now.
No.
That's why.
No, it just came off the.
Here we go. Let's talk some modeling questions. Modeling questions.
Gay,
okay.
So it came off. It's West Hollywood. What do you expect?
All right, come on. Let's get serious about this.
That's where I met Richard.
What?
Oh, Santa Monica.
What's Hollywood?
He met me doing the LGB or whatever it's called.
Yeah,
that's the lesbian gay movement, LGM.
Hey, come on now. All right. Now, what would you prefer to do right now? Put the mic up because my malcreados, they okay, now, what would you rather be doing? Modeling? What do you prefer, modeling or acting?
Well, definitely acting.
I
enjoy it because I get to work on characters, and you know, it is something that you work on, finding the character, and it can be challenging, and then you work at it every day.
I like that demo.
Did you
that was like my old demo.
Did you start off as a model and then went into acting?
When I was a little kid, I would do theater, and I would do just like little, you know, videos with my sisters, but it was never nothing. Like, we didn't even have a camera. Like, we pretended we were doing it.
Yeah, I know.
We're like little kids, and we're like filming.
That's a start.
Yes.
Yeah. No.
But we would create.
I would have watched.
Because Mexicanos, sometimes we can't afford all like a football or a camera. Yeah. Or I can't even afford cable.
We couldn't really afford a camera. So we would pretend we're filming. And we would do like, you know, escenas, scenes from movies or novelas.
Mm-hmm.
And then, so I did that first. And then when I was a few years later, I did some modeling. And
yeah.
And then, you know, I've been doing acting full time now.
Yeah, because from you, the pictures that I found of you, and it was just by chance that I found you on Facebook and the internet. Because I was looking for people to fill, young ladies, models, to fill our series. And I just couldn't find anybody.
Let's go with Blanca.
I said, what is this, Blanca? I said, I look at these pictures. I said, she looks like a model. And that's when I first contacted you. And you thought I was a creep. Probably when I first contacted. Everybody does. But then they find out that this is pretty legit. Quit patronizing. Come on, man. While I'm doing the interview.
He wants to take over the interview.
Yeah, I know.
He
showed
me his SAG card.
Oh, man. Where's security? Where's Richard at? The other Rich. Anyway, and so I saw these pictures, and that's why I thought, well, maybe she looks like a model. And then I started looking at all these pictures. I said, oh, yeah, this is nice. Let me see if I can get her in. And then I saw you, if you don't mind my mentioning, I saw you with John Savage. I said, wow, man, this lady, young lady. And then I wondered the next thing. She's Hispanic. Man, maybe she's Mexicana. Because, Blanca, we're all the Mexicanas. I do not see, even at that party the other night, I didn't see too many Mexicanas.
Oh.
In the entertainment industry, we have a lot of Sudamericanas, Centroamericanas that come through here, Puerto Ricans. But I do not see many Mexicanos or Mexicanas. Do you run into any?
Oh, for sure.
Really?
I don't see a lot of Mexicanos either. Or even, like, the movies that I do, like, I you know, sometimes I'm the only Latina in the movies.
Uh-huh.
So I know that it is something that is, it happens. I know things are changing.
Yeah.
what was the sound? They
need WD-40. They need oil, aceite. And so, what are all the Mexicans behind the scenes? Are they working the cameras and everything, or are they just doing the catering? Come on. Come on.
No, I'm.
That's funny.
I see a lot of behind the scenes, but I definitely, I'm beginning to see, I guess, there's more, like, you know, people getting nominations for Golden Globes, like Alejandro.
Oh,
and,
yeah.
And also.
And Del Toro.
Gina Rodriguez.
Gina,
yeah,
from
she was just nominated for Golden Globes.
For The Last Virgin, that one.
Yeah, or Jane the Virgin.
Oh, Jane the Virgin is. Rodriguez? There's a couple. There's one that is Mexicana from Texas.
Michelle Rodriguez.
Michelle Rodriguez. She's Mexicana,
mm-hmm.
And the other one from Jane the Virgin. She's Puerto Rican, I believe. She's from Miami. I met her. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
But yeah. I was surprised that Michelle Rodriguez is Mexicana.
Oh,
I read her bio. Yeah, she's from.
Oh, wow.
Because she looks Puerto Rican, and she's from.
She does.
Yeah, but I'm not talking about her. I'm talking about Blanca. So, yeah, you get me off track here. Okay, now the next thing. So, any advice while I have you here? Rocio gave her advice on young ladies seeking an opportunity to come to Hollywood to make it as a model or an actress. Any advice you'd like to give them right now?
Oh, yeah. Just stay focused, because you're gonna encounter challenges, because that's a given. Nothing happens automatic, it's a process.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, just stay focused and don't get distracted, and hang out with people that are positive, because you get a lot of negativity around you. So, you know, keep a tight circle, and don't get distracted, because if you get distracted, you're not gonna get far.
Oh, yes. Yeah. I like that answer. What, am I the only one in the house?
And
like that?
What's your diet? What's your diet?
See, they're not clapping because I'm holding the
microphone.
I have a higher degree than they do. I have a master's.
You know, I'm holding the microphone, and she looks like she watches her diet, by the way.
Well, I was going to tell you that.
Into fitness.
What is your routine? What do you do?
Okay. So,
to stay fit.
I've been a runner since I was in middle school. So I do running, and I do weights too.
Orale. What way you do weights? I can tell you about 5'10" because of your limbs. They're so long. You run around Hollywood, or do you run in a gym?
No, I live in Malibu, so I run over there.
Pardon.
Do you run on
con permiso?
No.
She runs on the sand.
Okay, be careful. I know a girl.
All right. this one's
affected her spinal column. It's serious.
I don't run. I run in the gym, in my treadmill.
And living in Malibu, the gym fees are what, like $1,000 a month or what?
No, it's pretty.
So you don't have to come. I'm just joking. I'm just joking. But you work. You run.
So
lift weights.
I do weights. I do cardio, and I eat healthy.
Every day.
No, I mean, I don't.
How often do you work out?
Just 4 to 5 times a week.
That's good. That's good.
I like to read and read my script. I mean, I like to run and then read my scripts at the same time.
Okay, well, who are you with? Richard, who are you with, though? Who is your manager or your agent?
Oh, I do have.
Why can we contact you?
Why?
How can people contact you?
Oh, you can go to my website, www.blancablanco.com.
Yeah, great website.
And then from there, you can find all my social media. You can find me on Instagram at Blanca Blanco Actress, Twitter at Blanca Blanco.
Yeah, and also on KCLA on YouTube, Pocho Loco Show. You can find that in a few months. You'll find her there. But so people will know, because I mean, you seem to work a lot. I mean, I looked at your filmography of IMDb. And you have quite a bit of credits. My gosh!
Well,
and
you know,
you've been working at this for over 10 years, haven't you?
No.
It looks like it.
No, I've been working it's been, I guess, 8 years.
Close.
Yeah, you were close, but I've been doing it full time for 5 years now.
I like this last Chicana.
Independent film. And
were you the last Chicana or what? From Washington?
No, so I just finished a movie with James Franco.
Okay.
In Dubious Battle. And
what's it called? Say it again.
In Dubious.
In Dubious Battle.
Battle. And it was with James Franco. He was a director. And then Vincent D'Onofrio, Josh Hutchinson. I can't really think of his last name. Hutchinson, yeah. And so we got to work in Atlanta and then in Washington State. No, in the Apple Field.
James Franco, huh?
Yeah.
Well, I guess I can't afford you now. James Franco. Can't afford James Franco. You know, he was one of my favorite actors currently. I'm taking him off the list.
he was great because he was a director, and then I did my scenes with him, and it was a great experience to be working with such an amazing cast.
Put it up there, Augie. The needle's going down. Okay.
Look for that.
You didn't like The Last Chicana because you had to pick out, what is that, the one you had to pick apples? Or
No. James Franco movie, I was an apple picker.
Now I'm going to beat him up. How dare he? How dare he put my Blanca Blanco as an apple picker?
And Selena Gomez, too.
I'm going to throw apples at him. I don't care. I don't care.
Selena.
What is this? Selena who?
Gomez.
The singer?
We were apple pickers.
You met her?
We worked together.
She's tall, huh?
Not that tall.
I mean, not as tall as you, but she's for Mexicana. She's.
Oh yeah. She's. Yeah.
You like the way she sings?
Oh, I love her.
Not you. Why is it on this show? You know, I give questions for my guests, and these guys are independent. No, come on now. Do you like her music?
Yeah,
I think that she's great.
Yeah.
She has a personality, and she's very likable.
Okay, I'm curious about this Beverly Hills Christmas. Now, what is that?
That just came out this month, and it's a Christmas movie. And it was out on Up TV.
Up TV, okay. Yeah, with
Dean Cain. He was the, you know, Lewis and Clark Superman. Mm-hmm. And it was a cute story about a spoiled little girl from Beverly Hills that wants everything, and then, you know, you go through some struggles, and then she appreciates the family and the value, what, you know, Christmas is about. And so it was great to work, you know, to work with your friends on that project. Mm-hmm.
Now in that movie, they didn't have you playing a maid or anything like that, did you?
No, I played an international supermodel.
Ooh. Orale, right? There you go.
I like that.
Yeah.
Can't go wrong with that.
Yeah.
And so, yeah, it was fun. I never played a model before.
But it seems like you do. Well, where is that one where you did the red carpet and you're wearing that gown and, you know, your backside is showing a little bit? You have done.
She has so many.
You have done runways, right?
I've done runway before.
Oh, Augie, you got to look at those pictures. Those are incredible. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
More research.
Yeah. So yeah, I mean, it's been great. You know, it's an industry that is very interesting, and it's not consistent. It's not linear. There's always like changes. Mm-hmm. So you gotta be able to face the changes, because it can definitely be challenging.
How far can a model go with age? Because people don't tend to think that their lifespan is very long on the runway.
Oh, for runway, yeah, they're very, very picky with that, with the age.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, like Adriana Lima, she's been doing Victoria's Secret for 18 years now, and
I've been a big fan every one of those years, till I met Blanca Blanco.
Yeah, I mean, so I think that. You just have, you know, she stays very focused, and she's still doing it, and she looks better than she did before, you know, when she started. I mean, she looks amazing.
Well, I've seen some of your earlier pictures, and you look just as nice as when, you know, years before. Now, the height thing with models, they have to be a certain height, like ballerinas, you know, is that something that's just required?
Yeah, I know for runway they want you to be at least 5'9" and up.
Oh, whoa.
And so that's not, you know, there's a lot of people that want to do modeling, but then they don't have the height, and it's unfortunate that, you know, you have the, they have a criteria, like designers want like specific height, they want specific weight. I mean, it is very like.
Are you a vegan?
No, I like meat.
What? There you go. Tacos, that kind of thing.
Oh, yeah. I just don't like pork.
Birria.
I mean, I love Mexican food. That's my favorite.
I don't like that.
You don't?
Birria. I can't get in that. Goat. You like that?
Mm. I don't need goat.
Yeah.
Because I. Yeah.
It's good.
Good for you.
No, I was. I ate it over.
It smells. It's got a strong smell.
It has a smell, and you know, I used to drive.
You don't smell.
Yeah, because you're used to the smell. It becomes normal.
Because everybody thinks the models, all the models are just, you know, they're vegan or they can't eat this, especially red meat and all that. But I'm glad to hear that. Do models make in a year, I would say, do they make really more money than actresses?
I think it depends on what you do. Like if you do a lot of print work and campaigns, like, you know, you make decent money. But I think it just depends on the project, because actors do make, you know, if you're in the union, you do, you have, like, you know, you make good money, but it just depends.
Okay, well, let's wrap it up. My friends, listeners, this has been the Pocho Loco Show with Blanca Blanco. Thank you for coming in. Anything you will do in film, of course, I'm a film guy, not too much of a TV guy. I will go check it out. Anything you'd like to promote right now as we wind down? Anything? It's yours. You know, whatever. I'm doing this. I'm doing that. What? I'm cooking menudo on Christmas. Whatever.
No. I don't like the smell.
Oh boy, here we go.
No, again. I mean, I like to eat it sometimes, but I cannot have it in the house because then it smells. It's like guts. You know,
it's kind of like Mexican house. No, but anything. Come on, we got some time. We got a minute.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Well, just, you know.
You gave out your website. What's your current project right now?
Well, I just finished a movie with Christopher Coppola. He was a director. And we shot in Belize.
Mm-hmm.
It's called The Torch.
Oh,
and
okay.
That one is going to be out next year also. And it was, you know, it was Francis Coppola production. And we shot in an island in Belize. And
is that his nephew or something?
Nephew. And then he's a brother of Nicolas Cage.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm. So it was great.
In the family.
It was a good experience. I never been in a jungle before. And I step on a snake. That was scary.
Oh, God.
You know what?
And then
there's your answer.
What?
This girl worked with some big people. She's in a big film. You mentioned earlier about...
Get out there and watch Concussion and Creed. Two sports-related dramas.
Oh, yeah. I like Concussion.
Oh, you saw it already?
I went to the premiere.
Blanca Blanco. Muchas gracias por
venir.
All
right, Blanca.
Blanca, muchas gracias por venir.
Igualmente, mucho gusto conocerlos. Una
señorita muy bella.
Gracias.
Con mucho talento.
Okay. Tan más bella.
Tan más desmasiada. All right. All right,
no,
hasta la próxima.
Demasiadamente.
Okay. Oh, she's always trying to outdo me. All right, this one's for Blanca as we leave you. Check out those. Surfing.
Adios, amigos. Hasta la vista.
Do you love me? Do you surf a girl? Surf a girl? Surf a girl? We could ride the surf together. Yeah.
I love the colorful clothes she wears and the way the sunlight plays upon her hair. I hear the sound of a gentle wind on the wind that lifts her perfume through the air. I'm picking up good vibrations. She's giving me the excitations. I'm picking up good vibrations. She's giving me the excitations. Good vibrations. She's giving me the excitations. Good vibrations. She's giving me the excitations. Close my eyes. She's somehow closer now. Softly smile, I know she must be kind.
She's